I'm Dr. Jianqiang Zhang from Iowa State University. It's a pleasure to be here to share some data on how we use PMAC cell lines to improve pulse bus isolation from clinical samples. So we all know that pulse improved by two genotypes. Pulse 1 is an EU strain, and pulse 2 is a North American strain. So we all know that pulse can cause respiratory and reproductive disorders and has a significant economic impact to small industries. So that's why it is critically important to have the pulse diagnostic tools to better monitor and control pulse. So there are several pulse detection assays. Example, some is a viral nucleosis based assay, example PCR and sequencing. Some is a viral antigen based assay, example immunohistochemistry and tissue FA testing, and also for to detect the infectious virus like virus isolation. Of course, you have some serological assays, example the ELISA, the FA antibody testing, neutralization test to detect the antibody. But today we will just focus on the virus isolation, okay? So for the, you may wonder, oh, now we have this PCR, we can detect the pulse, why we still want virus isolation? Well, PCR is to detect the nucleosid and then to want to tell you if there's a live virus or not. Virus isolation can detect live virus. But please keep in mind, if you request a VI, you got a positive result, then it will tell you there's a live virus in the sample, not a problem. But if you get a VI negative, it doesn't 100% mean that there's no live virus there. It's just because of some limitation and the sensitivity issue of the cell lines used for VI, okay? And second, if you obtain the virus isolate, you can use it for vaccine production, including autogenous vaccine production, and also can use this virus isolate to further characterize the virus's virulence, pathogenesis, and so on. And also you can use the virus isolate to develop some specific assay, example, virus strain specific FA antibody assay, virus strain specific neutralization test. And we can go on and on, but just to give you some examples here. And so how to do the virus isolation? For PRRS, traditionally, two tools. One is the PEM cells, is the porcine alveolar macrophages. This is the primary cells, okay? So this can support most of the PRRS strains. But it is the primary cells, and it's difficult to propagate it, and also that could be the variation between different batches. You also need to periodically prepare the PEM cells. The second tool is the MAC145 cell line. This is the cell line most commonly used in majority of the labs for PRRS virus isolation. But the success rate, sometimes could be the frustrating. It's a kind of low. No. So now we have this ZMAC cell line. It's derived from PEM cells. We are going to share some data about this. So my graduate student did this study with several objectives. First is to compare the PRRS VI in MAC145 and ZMAC cells using the clinical samples, and then to evaluate the correlation of the PRRS concentration, example the CT values and the specimen types to VI success. Then to compare the virus titers you obtained in these two cell lines, what about the titer comparison? And also we wanted to know if this PRRS isolate obtained in ZMAC cells can grow in MAC145 cells or not, and then vice versa, okay. So here is some data on the PRRS 2 VI. We have this 220 PRRS 2 PCR positive samples. This is what used for VI comparison in two cell lines. This including 95 serum, 91 lung samples, and 34 oral flu samples with different CT ranges. But you can see that for this oral flu sample, the CT is kind of high. It's just difficult to obtain the oral flu samples with very low CT values, okay? So if you look at this result among the 95 serum samples, about 43% VI positive in ZMAC cells, 8% positive in MAC cells. Lung, 91, about 67% success in ZMAC, 48% positive in MAC cells. For oral flow samples, unfortunately, zero positive in either cell lines. If you combine this serum and lung samples, totally the 186 samples, about 55% positive in ZMAC cells and 28% positive in MAC145 cells. Then here shows the 2x2 tables. You can see that among the 102 PRRSV positive in ZMAC cells, only 45 positive in MAC cells, 57 negative here. In contrast, among the 52 positive in MAC cells, majority also positive by ZMAC, only a few, you know, negative in ZMAC cells. So here is to show the CT ranges. So basically, when the CT is less than 30, is a pretty good success rate in ZMAC cells, especially compared to MAC145 cells. But when the CT levels is over 30, success rate is lower, no matter which cell line you use. So that's why sometimes we recommend if you have the CT higher than 30, probably you do not want to request the VI. Success rate won't be very good. So now let's look at the PRRSV1. We only tested 51 PRRSV1 PCR positive samples. Again, this including the 21 serum, 8 lung, and 22 oral flow with the different CT ranges. Again, the 22 oral flow samples, the CT pretty high. And if you look at here, success rate, similarly, you have the highest success rate in ZMAC cells compared to MAC cells. Again, oral fluid, we didn't get any positive. Then this combines the serum and the lung for PRRSV1, about 38% positive in ZMAC and 14% positive in MAC cells. 11 positive in ZMAC cells, among those, only 4 positive in MAC cells. 7 negative, all of these are 4 positive in MAC cells, also positive by ZMAC cells. So, again, for the CT range, and CT less than 30, better in ZMAC cells, CT higher than 30, not good in either cell line. And then, the next question we want to know, what about this virus titer in this 2 cell line, which is better, which not? To compare that, we select 20 samples. All of these 20 samples are PRRSV positive in both cell lines, okay? But the first is, if we get the isolate in MAC cells, we just do the titration in MAC cells. If VI positive in ZMAC, we did the titration here. So this is just the show your data. So among these 20 samples, and 14 of them, have the comparable titers between the 2 cell lines. So basically, the range from the 4 to 6 logs, okay? And 5 of them have a high titer in ZMAC cells, you know, showing the red color. So, and then 1 has a slightly high titer in MAC145 cells. So you can appreciate this about the titer difference. Majority of them comparable. And then the next question is whether this isolate you obtained from ZMAC cells can grow in MAC145 cells or not. In order to test that, we select 84 PRRSV2 isolate obtained in ZMAC cells and put back to MAC cells. It turned out that 45 of them, you know, is about 54% grew in MAC cells. And 46% did not grow. What about the isolate obtained in MAC cells? Well, we put 43, those are isolate obtained from MAC cells back to ZMAC cells. 100% of them grew in ZMAC cells. So for this part of work, you know, the conclusion that PRRS was not isolated from any oral fluid sample in this study is, as I mentioned, the CT is one factor, okay? Pretty high CTs. So if you have these clinical samples with this CT less than 30, you will have the high success rate in ZMAC cells compared to MAC145 cells. So for these samples with VI positive in both cell lines, majority of them have similar titers. But keep in mind that I said about 54% of the ZMAC-derived isolate grew in microglia-45 cells. Almost that's half, you know, 46% did not grow. If in your industry or company, you just use microglia-45 cells to propagate the PRRS for autogenous vaccine production, you just need to keep this information in mind. Okay. So basically, we do believe that ZMAC cell lines provide one additional tool for PRRS virus isolation and further characterization. So the next two slides, I just want to briefly share with you about this diagnostic submission flow, okay? If you are the veterinarians, you submit the samples to us at ICUVDL. Generally speaking, you will first request a PRRS PCR, okay? Right? If you got a positive, then you say, oh, please do virus isolation and then forward isolate to which company for, you know, autogenous vaccine production. So if you do not specifically make a request, we generally try the VI in microglia-45 cells first. If we got a positive, that's good. If it's a negative, and if the CT less than 25, we automatically put it in ZMAC cells. Okay. But if you already talked to our immune company, you specifically say, oh, we just want you to directly do VI in ZMAC cells. Don't need to waste time in doing the microglia-45 cells. No problem. We will just directly do VI in ZMAC cells. Once we get a positive, we can, you know, forward isolate. And then, let's say if we get the VI positive in ZMAC cells, I or, you know, Dr. Gog, we will send a veterinary request form to the submitting veterinarians. We will need you to sign the form and authorize us to forward the isolate to the Diamond Lab. And we will really appreciate it if you can sign that and return to us sooner or better. Because sooner we receive that, faster we can forward the isolate to the Diamond Lab. According to the Diamond Lab, if there's a no signed form by the veterinarian, they won't accept the isolate we forward to them, okay? So we really appreciate it if you can sign and give that form back to us. And also, for this isolate obtained in ZMAC cells before forwarding to Diamond Lab, we run some purity testing to verify that this PRRS isolate is negative for influenza, negative for PCV2, negative for mycoplasma high pneumonia, and mycoplasma high rhinitis, and mycoplasma high eosinophil. So after all of this purity testing is done, we have this veterinary request form. And then we will just assign the standard MTA between ICU and the Diamond Lab, and we forward isolate to them to start the process of autogenous vaccine production. So this study was mainly done by my great student, Wong Ray Ning Yin, and also appreciate Dr. Phil Goger, Jim Park, and Ian for the help. Also appreciate the Gabby and Steve Berg and Eric from Amy for the help. This project was partially funded by the American Association of Swine Veterinary Foundation, and also appreciate that the Aptimmune, you know, donated some money to support my research. Without that, I will stop here and take any questions. Thank you.
Have you done any genotype analysis of the
viruses
growing
marks because
Z-lines as to what kind of lineage they are?
Very good question. Yes, we have those data. We haven't done any statistical analysis to see that correlation. And but I can tell you, majority of these PRRS positive samples in U.S. belong to the lineage 1589. Only this majority of these four lineages. And it's of course, you know, there's a publication indicated that there's a 9 inches of PRRS2 worldwide. But some, you know, and just present in Asian countries. In US, we have done some preliminary analysis. The majority, I just said, 1, 5, 8, 9, those lineages. But the problem is that we have also, you know, like over 200 samples. Sometimes it's lineage 1 and 8, you have more and
other lineages, but anyhow, that is in progress. We have provided the data to one statistician to do that analysis.